And turning to a hospital further north, it's been 15 years since Englewood Hospital pioneered bloodless medicine and surgery, a technique proven to reduce infections and save lives. Now the Department of Defense wants its military doctors to learn it, so the DOD has turned to Englewood for training. NJN News health and medical correspondent Sarah Lee Kessler has that story.
Say money.
Englewood Hospital and Medical Center is celebrating a major achievement. It's been awarded a nearly $4.7 million Defense Department grant to teach military doctors what it knows about bloodless medicine and surgery. The hospital is an internationally recognized leader in the field. To date, it's treated more than 50,000 patients. Congressman Steve Rothman, who's a big supporter of the hospital, he was born here, says he lobbied for the grant after learning about the program.
A light bulb went off in my head, and I said, wow, this is something that our military could use to save the lives of our men and women on the battlefield.
We'll use a cell saver now.
Englewood developed its bloodless approach 15 years ago to serve a Jehovah's Witness community that would not accept blood. It's been used for everything from gastric procedures to cardiac bypass surgery. Proponents say going bloodless promotes healing, reduces infection, and saves lives.
It reduces exposure of patients to bank blood, which is associated with negative outcomes.
How do you think this will help on the battlefield?
Tremendously, because there are always complications associated with transfusion. We're going to save lives.
Military experts also believe the blood management program will be a tremendous asset when natural disasters strike, like the one in Haiti, because that's a time when medical supplies, including blood, are hard to come by.
We should use transfusion as a last resort.
Dr. R.E.A. Shander is founder and executive medical director of Englewood's Bloodless Medicine Program. He says with military doctors, he'll focus on the importance of the cell saver, which collects and recycles a patient's own blood.
Here's an opportunity with a cell saver to collect the patient's own blood that's shed from surgery, wash it, and then return it as fresh autologous, meaning your own blood, back to your circulation.
The hope is that bloodless medicine will improve survival rates for wounded soldiers. Sarah Lee Kessler, NJN News, Englewood.
Innovation often comes where we least expect it.
We said, why are they doing okay without blood?
14 years ago, a group of Jehovah's Witnesses asked Englewood Hospital to develop a system where they could have surgery without blood transfusions, which is forbidden in their religion.
We saw a year after practicing this way that the witness patients were getting complex surgery and medical care without using blood.
The hospital created the Institute for Patient Blood Management after research began showing that performing surgeries without blood transfusions, known as bloodless surgery, eliminated many complications. Instead, patients just have to have a strong blood count. Bloodless medicine utilizes technologies such as oxygen therapy and blood recycling that can help minimize blood loss and also enhance the blood supply. On Friday, the hospital's institute got a boost with $4.69 million in federal funding to train military and civilian physicians in bloodless medicine and surgery. The lower cost of performing surgery without transfusions made it a particularly appealing government program.
When one can reduce complications, reduce infections, reduce durations in the hospital, reduce mortality as a result of surgeries, and save money at the same time, that's a grand slam.
The program will be run through the U.S. Army and aims to help Army doctors become less dependent on blood supplies in war zones or trauma situations.
The complication list is very long, and so we only want to use blood transfusion as a last resort.
As the Institute uses bloodless medicine for more varied surgeries, the hope is that it will soon become the standard method.
Bloodless medicine and surgery can be applied across the board to transplantation, to trauma, to anything else.
Now, with a larger platform to spread the new methods across the globe. In Englewood, Allie Rosen for your New Jersey News Now on New York One.